Okay guys, this is the solution of your homework for page 318. Find the coefficient of x cubed and of x6 in the expansion of 1 minus 3x to the power of 8. Yeah. So we have to find x cubed. That means I will write 8c something, and then I will write 1, and then negative 3x. Okay. Because the questions want us to find the x cubed, so I have to write 3 right there, and then I have to write 3 again right here, and then 8 minus 3 equals to 5. I will write 5. So the result will be 8c3 equals to 56 times 1 times negative 27 x cubed. So the result is 56 times negative 27. Negative 1512 x cubed. This is the coefficient of x cubed. Yeah, so the coefficient is negative 1512. Next, 1 minus 3x to the power of 8. I want to find the coefficient of x6. So I will write 8c something, and then 1 to the power of something, negative 3x to the power of something. Because the question want us to find the x6, I want to try 6 right there, and then 6 right here, and then 8 minus 6 equals to 2. Okay, so 8c6 equals to 28 times 1 times 3 to the power of 6 is 729 positive. Yeah, so the result will be 28 equals to 20412x6. So the coefficient of the x6 will be 20412. Okay, good. Next. Okay, we are still on page 318. In the expansion of 1 minus 2x to the power of 12, 1 minus 2x to the power of 11, the coefficient of x cubed. Yeah, so we have to find the coefficient of x cubed. That means I will write 1c something, and then 1 to the power of something, to the power of something, negative 2x to the power of something. I want to find the x cubed, so I will write 3 right here, and then 3 right here, and then 11 minus 3 equals to 8. The result will be 11c3 equals to 165, and then 1, and then negative 8x cubed. Yeah, so the result is 165 times 8 equals to negative 1320x cubed. So the coefficient is negative 1320x cubed. Next, I want to find the coefficient of x squared. Yeah, 11, so 11c something, and then 1 to the power of something, negative 2x to the power of something. I want to find the x squared, so I have to write 2 right here, and then 2 right there, and then 11 minus 2 equals to 9, equals to 11c2 equals to 55 times 1 times negative, it's 4x squared equals to 55 times 4, 220x square. Okay, and then I want to read this sentence. Okay, the coefficient of x cubed is k times the coefficient of x squared. Let's translate that sentence into mathematical expressions. So the coefficient of x cubed is negative 1320, and then is equal k times the coefficient of x squared is 220. I can use algebra to solve this. Negative 1320 divided by 220 equals to negative 6. So the k is negative 6. The question is evaluate k, so k will be negative 6. Okay, the next is number 13a. Find the ratio of the coefficient of 4th and the 6th term in expansion of this. So I will try to find the 4th term first. 1 plus 2x to the power of 16. For the first, for the 4th term, I have to write 16c3. Yeah, remember the term needs to be subtract by 1. Yeah, minus 1. So it's 1 and then 2x, because I write 3 right here, so I have to write 3 right there, and then 16 minus 3 equals to 13. And then use your calculator to solve this. 16c3 and then times 2 to the power of 3 equals to 4480x to the power of cube. Okay, next is the sixth term. The sixth term will be 1 plus 2x to the power of 16. I will write 16c5 and then 1 and then 2x to the power of 5. 16 minus 5 equals to 11. The result is 16c5 times 2 to the power of 5. Okay, the result is 139776x to the power of 5. Okay, and then read this sentence. The coefficient of 4. Oh, sorry. The ratio of the coefficient of the 4th and the 6th term. Yeah, the ratio. So we have to find the ratio. The ratio will be 4480 to 139776. Okay, you can use your calculator to simplify this. Yeah, just press the fraction button and then you write 4480 over 139776, and then press the SD to get fraction answer, and the fraction says 5 to 156, so the ratio is 5 to 156. Yeah, okay, like this. Next is 13b. For 13b, the coefficient of x squared, so I have to find the coefficient of x squared of 1 minus ax to the power of 24. That means I have to write 24 c something and then 1 to the power of something and then negative ax to the power of 2, yeah, because the question want us to find x squared. So this one will be 2, and then 24 minus 2 is 22. The result is 24c2 equals to 276, and then 1, and then negative a square equals to a square, x square equals to x square. So the simplest form is like this. Okay, and then the question say that the coefficient of x square is 69. So this is the coefficient of x square. I can write 276 a square equals to 69, and then a square equals to 69 over 276. So a square equals to 69 divided by 276, 1 over 4, guys. So a equals to square root of 1 over 4. Don't forget the plus minus. A equals to plus minus and half. And then keterangannya a greater than 0, so I have to choose the a equals to half. Yeah, a equals to half. The negative half is rejected. Next, the coefficient of x cubed. So after I get the a, I can change the questions into 1 minus half. Yeah, tadi a nya half, x to the power of 24. Now the question want us to find the coefficient of x cubed, so I will write 24 c something and then 1 and then negative half x to the power of something, coefficient of x cubed, so I have to write 3 right here, 3 right here, and then 24 minus 3 is 21 equals to 24 c3 times 1 over 253 x cubed negative. Okay, so the coefficient is negative 253. Yeah. Okay, the next is number 7, page 321. In the expansion of this, find the term in x 10. Yeah, find the term. Okay, so x cubed minus 2 over x squared to the power of 10. The question want us to find the term of x 10. So I will write 10 C something, and then x to the power 3 to the power of something. For this one, I will write like this, negative 2 over x squared. I can rewrite the x squared into x to the power of negative 2 at the top, yeah, to the power of something. Because you don't know the something, what is the something, so I will let the something equals to p. This one also p. This one is 10 minus p. Yeah. The question want us to find the coefficient of x10. Sorry, the term of x10. Okay. So I will try to multiply the x. Yeah. So the x is 10 to the power. X to the power of 3, and then to the power of 10 minus p. Times again with x minus 2 to the power of 3 needs to be equal to yang dia mau, ya, yang dia mau x to the power of 10. Okay, let's try to find the p first. X to the power of 10 equals to x to the power of 30 minus 3p times x to the power of negative 2p. So x to the power of 10 equals to x to the power of 30 minus 5p. So the x is already the same. I can tell that 10 equals to 30 minus 5p, and then negative 20 equals to negative 5p, p equals to 4. So after I get the p, I can calculate the term of x to the power of 10. Yeah. So the term will be 10c4 times x cubed to the power of 10 minus 4 equals to 6, and then negative 2 x to the power of negative 2 to the power of 4. Okay, let's prove that the term will be x to the power of 10, ya. 10c4 equals to 210 times x to the power of 18 times negative 2 to the power of 4 is 16 times x to the power of negative 8 times it again one more time times 16 equals to 3360 x to the power of 18 times x to the power of negative 8 is x to the power of 10. Okay, there you go, we already have x to the power of 10, yeah. The term is 3360. And then 7b, the coefficient of 1 over x to the power of 5, or I can say the question want us to find x to the power of negative 5, yeah. So the way is the same like before, 10, so 10cp times x cubed times negative 2 x to the power of negative 2. So let this one is p, this one will be 10 minus p, yeah. And then to find the coefficient of x negative 5, I have to find the p first, like this. X to the power of negative 5 equals to x to the power of 3 powers again 10 minus p, and then times with x to the power of negative 2 power of p. Next, let's simplify this one. X to the power of 30 minus 3p times x to the power of negative 2p. Multiply them. X to the power of negative 5 equals to x to the power of 30 minus 5p, and then cross out the x. Negative 5 equals to 30 minus 5p. Negative 35 equals to negative 5p. So I will get p equals to 7. After I get p, I can change the questions like this. Equals to 10c7, ya. X to the power of 3 to the power of 10 minus 7 equals to 3, and then negative 2 x to the power of negative 2 to the power of p, p is 7. So let's calculate this. 10c7, 120 times x to the power of 9 times negative 128 times x to the power of negative 14. So the result is 120 times negative 128, negative 15360 x to the power of negative 5. Okay, the coefficient. So the coefficient is negative 15360. That is number 7b. Next is 7c. 7c, the constant term. Constant term means x to the power of 0, yeah. It doesn't have x, yeah. because it doesn't have x, we can say that the variables will be x to the power of 0. We will do it like before, 2x squared to the power of 10 equals to 10 c something, and then x cubed, and then negative 2x to the power of negative 2 p. This one is p, this one is 10 minus p. Let's try to find the p. X to the power of 0 equals to x to the power of 30 minus 3p, yeah, just like before, x power negative 2p. So x to the power of 0 equals to x to the power of 30 minus 5p, and then you can cross out the x. 0 equals to 30 minus 5p, negative 30 equals to negative 5p, so p will be 6, yeah. And then put the p into our calculation, c6, x cubed to the power of 10 minus 6 is 4, negative 2x negative 2 to the power of 6. Okay, let's calculate this, equals to 10c6 equals to 210, and then x to the power of 12, and then this one is 64, x to the power of negative 12, 10 times 64 equals to 13440. X to the power of 12, x to the power of negative 12 equals to 0, yeah. X to the power of 0, so the constant will be 13440. Okay, that is for number 7. Yeah, we already finished 7. The last one is 8. Expand half minus 2x to the power of 5 up to the term x cube. So let's expand this first. 5 equals to 5c0, and then plus 5c1, and then plus 5c2, and then plus 5c3. I think it's enough. So this one is half, and then negative 2x. Yeah, the powers 0, 1, 2, 3, okay, x cube, yeah, up to the term in x cube. We already got the x cube, so we stop right here, and then this one will be 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, I will use my calculator first and then give the result. Okay, so the result is like this, yeah. And then the second question is, if the coefficient of x square in the expansion of this is 13/2, find the coefficient of x cube. Okay, let's try to find the coefficient of x square of multiplication 1 plus ax plus 3x square times with half minus 2x to the power of 5, yeah. Let's try to find the coefficient of x square. Okay, so I can write this questions like this, and then I can change the binomial into the result that we got before. 5 over 8x plus 5x squared negative 20x cubed, and then so on. Okay, because the question want us to find the x square only, the coefficient of x square, so I have to times this one with 5x squared, yeah, to become x squared. Okay, so the result is 5x squared, and then for the ax, I have to times it with negative 5 over 8x, yeah, so the x will become x squared one more time. So the result is negative 5 over 8a x squared, and then for the last one, 3x squared, I have to times it with this one, so the x will be x squared, yeah, plus 3 over 32 x squared. Okay, we already have all of the term in x squared. The question says the coefficient of x squared is 13/2. So this one is the coefficient of x squared, this one is the coefficient of x squared, this one is the coefficient of x squared. The coefficient equals to 13/2 equals to 5 minus 5 over 8a, and then plus 3/32. I will times them all with 32, yeah, So the first one become 13 times 16 equals to 208 equals to 150 minus 428 and then 13. 208 minus 160 minus 3 equals to 45 equals to negative 28. So I will get A equals to 45 divided by 20, negative 2.25. There you go. We already have the A. Okay, so because we are have the A right now, I can change again the formula and the formula the questions into 1 minus 2.25x plus 3x square times with half minus 2x to the power of 5. Yeah, this one. Okay, I change this A into negative 2.25x. And then let's read the question one more time. Find the coefficient of x cube. Yeah. Now we have to find the coefficient of x cube. So I will rewrite the question first with the expansion of the binomial plus 3x square times it with apa tadi? Okay, this one ya. Wait, let me copy it first. Okay, so times with this one, the expansion. Okay, next the question want us to find the coefficient of x cube. So I can tell that the first term 1 needs to be times with negative 20 x cube. The result is negative 20 x cube. And then for the second term, I have to times it with x square to become x cube. Yeah. So the result is 2.25 times 5 equals to 11.25 negative. Negative 11.25 x cube. And then for the last one, 3x square needs to be times with negative 5 over 8 ya, equals to negative 15 over 8 x cube. Okay, let's calculate this using calculator. Negative 20, negative 11.25 minus 15 over 8. The result is negative 33.125 x cube. What is the questions again? The questions is coefficient. So the coefficient is negative 33.125. Yeah, the answer is okay. That's correct. Okay, guys, this is the solution of your homework. So I hope you can understand it well. We will meet again in my next video. Bye bye.